Greetings in the name of Jesus. Thank God for this moment. Thank God for this opportunity that God has given us to be alive once again and to have an opportunity to listen to the Word of God. And it's a privilege, it's a joy and a privilege to me for me to be able to speak to you on the first day of 2022. I know to those of you who are listening in from Fiji, it will be the second day for you. But for those of us from this part of the world, it is still the afternoon or the evening of the first day of 2022. And it's an honor to be able to speak to you once again, to bring to you the Word of God. And I believe God is going to speak to us in His own special way, in His message that He is going to share with us. Through the Holy Spirit. And I want to greet you and welcome you all from wherever you are tuning in from, different places, different areas, different part of the world that you may be listening in from, or maybe you will listen to this sermon right after this. It's a joy to be able to speak to you once again, bringing you the Word of God. And I pray that the Lord will bless you as we listen to the Word of God together this evening and this morning to those of you tuning in from Fiji. Will you please close your eyes and bow your heads and let us thank God for this moment. Father, we come before you once again, Lord. We thank you. We praise you. We give you praises for all that you have done for us in the past year leading up to this moment. Lord, we are reaching this year alive and well, not because of how good we are, not because of our strength, not because of our knowledge and our wisdom and our power, but because of you. We are here because of you, Lord, and we thank you. We praise you. We give you the glory and the honor for all that you have ever done for us, bringing us thus far with you, leading us all the way. We thank you, Holy Spirit. We welcome you. We acknowledge your presence. Thank you that you will minister your word to us once again. Thank you that you will bring to us the uncompromising word that we need to change. We need to live in such a way that will glorify you all the rest of our days. Father, I thank you for this moment. We welcome 2022. With you leading us all the way. We commit our lives to you, Holy Spirit. Come and lead us, come and guide us. According to what Jesus says about you, you will lead us and guide us into all truth. And we yield ourselves to you. Come and lead us once again, Holy Spirit. Thank you for this moment. Thank you for your word. Lord, I pray for your children who are listening in and those who will be watching this later on. Lord, I pray that you will anoint them, that you will bless them. You will empower them. You will enlighten the eyes of their understanding for them to see the importance of living for you, walking in the Holy Spirit, as you will say to us tonight. We thank you and we praise you. We ask you for your forgiveness if there are things that we have ever done or committed or say that is contradicting to your word. We ask you, Holy Spirit, please forgive us once again. Lord, I thank you and I praise you for this moment. Those that might be driving, listening to this sermon, Lord, I pray in the name of Jesus that you will bless them. Lord, I thank you. I give you praise and I give you glory. We ask all these things in Jesus' name we pray. Amen and amen. 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 We greet you once again in the matchless name, the mighty name of Jesus. Thank you for your time. Thank you for giving your time to sit down, to listen to the Word of God. It's an honor, it's a joy, and it's a privilege to be able to share with you the Word of God. Apologies for my voice is not sounding good at the moment, but I believe that you will get the message. Amen. Even if my voice is not that clear to you all, but I believe with the help of the Holy Spirit that you will get the message. Amen. The title of our sermon this evening, first sermon through the ministry, this evening or this morning to those of you watching from Fiji, is this: allow the Holy Spirit to flip the table. Allow the Holy Spirit to flip the table. If you can please go with me to the book of Matthew chapter 21, beginning from verse 12. Matthew chapter 21, beginning from verse 12. Like I said, allow the Holy Spirit to flip the table. You know, all throughout the year 2021, there are so many tables that we have before us. You know, coming to the year of 2022, we need to allow the Holy Spirit to flip the table. Let the Holy Spirit flip the table. The only way that you can change is for you to allow him to flip the table. Don't brush him off when he is convicting you. Don't do that. Just go with the flow of the Holy Spirit and listen and be obedient to what the Holy Spirit is going to say to you. He wants to come in into the temple, which is your body, to flip the table that has already been set in your heart. There are so many tables that we have set before us that we prioritize, but this morning or tonight, the Holy Spirit is convicting us to flip the table. Matthew chapter 21, beginning from verse 12, then Jesus went into the temple of God and drove out all those who bought and sold in the temple and overturned the tables of the money changers and the seats of those who sold doves. Two things he overturned here. Okay, number one, the Bible says that he overturned the tables and the seats of those who sold doves. And he said to them, it is written, my house shall be called a house of prayer, but you have made it a den of thieves. I will read it again from the book of Matthew chapter 21, beginning from verse 12. Then Jesus went into the temple of God and drove out all those who bought and sold in the temple and overturned the tables of money changers and the seats of those who sold doves. And he said to them, it is written, my house shall be called a house of prayer, but you have made it a den of thieves. In order for us to clean the temple of the Holy Spirit, which is our body, beloved, we must allow the Holy Spirit. We must allow the Holy Spirit to come in and flip the table. There are so many tables that we have before us. There are so many tables that we have set before us that God is not approved of. God does not agree with those tables. God does not approve those tables. And the sad thing is that there are so many tables that we have in our churches. There are so many tables that we have in our congregation. And we allow those people to set up those tables. We allow the devil to set up his table inside the church. We need to allow the Holy Spirit. Let him do his job. Let him do what he is planning to do. If that means to flip the tables, then let him do it. Amen. If we want the Holy Spirit to lead us and to guide us, we must allow him to come in, cleanse the temple, flip the table, and let him take control. There are some of the tables that we have set before us in the past. There are so many tables that we haven't flipped coming to 2022 that we used to set up in 2021. We prioritize things in our lives, and we need to let that go. We need to allow the Holy Spirit to come into the temple, which is your body. There are so many things that you have set up before you. There are so many things that we know that is not according to the word of God. But because everybody is doing it, we think it is okay. But the Holy Spirit is the only one that will convict you so that you know that it's important to allow him to flip the table so that we can change. God wants the best for us. But in order for him to release his best for you, he needs to come in and flip the table first. Amen. He needs to come in. You need to allow him. You need to let the Holy Spirit to come into your life and flip the table and flip the seat that you have been sitting on for so long that you think is right. It's comfortable. You think it's right, but it's not right in the eyes of God. We need change. We want change to happen in our lives. We want changes to happen in our marriage. We want our children to change. We want our future to change. We want a better tomorrow. We want a better year of 2022. But we must allow, right from the very beginning, beloved, right from the very beginning, we must allow the Holy Spirit to come in and let him flip the table around so that you know what he is trying to do, so that you know his plan and his purpose in your life. The very thing that is stopping God from showing you how good he is, how faithful he is that you have been dwelling so long on that table. You have been seated so long on that seat. You are feeding from a table that does not satisfy you anymore. Nothing in this world will satisfy you. Money cannot satisfy you. Fame cannot satisfy you. Alcohol cannot satisfy you. Living a loose life cannot satisfy you. The world cannot satisfy you. Satisfaction comes from Jesus alone. And in order for Jesus to show himself powerful on your behalf, you must allow the Holy Spirit to come in and flip the table and allow Jesus to manifest himself into your lives. The reason why it's important to allow the Holy Spirit to come in and flip the table is because Jesus said, when the Holy Spirit comes, he will reveal myself to you. That's what Jesus said. He said, the Holy Spirit will reveal me to you. Just as I come from the Father, I reveal the Father to you. And when Thomas asked him, Father, Jesus, how can we know the way? How can we know the Father? And Jesus said to Thomas, Thomas, as soon as you see me, you see the Father. So Jesus came to us and revealed the Father. And then he said, I will go back now to the Father. I will send the Holy Spirit. He will reveal me to you. So in order for you to know the full extent of the power of Jesus, the grace of Jesus, the blood of Jesus, you need to allow the Holy Spirit to come in and flip the table. Amen. You need to allow the Holy Spirit. You cannot know Jesus without the Holy Spirit. Sani rawa. Ninda mekele chisu. Kenta sani batarana. Vangani ala tamuni kolomena. Kido kwa na tepeli. Ena elonda. E sona tepeli enda. Ndambe toko kine na. Kabe nindai. Tiko kilaba wabi nakasara tuma. You know full well that table that you are, that you set before you, never give you any satisfaction anymore. Money can give you satisfaction, but to an extent. But the Holy Spirit is trying to reveal to you the Jesus that I'm talking about tonight. And the only way for you to know full well the power of Jesus, the miracle working power of Jesus, is for you to lap the Holy Spirit, because that's the Holy Spirit's job, is to reveal Jesus to you. And if you kept on ignoring the Holy Spirit, how then can you know Jesus? How can you witness the power of Jesus if you don't allow the Holy Spirit to flip the table, to change you into the person that you want, that God wants you to be, and then he will reveal Jesus to you? If Jesus said that the Holy Spirit will come and reveal himself to us, then that doesn't change. It has never changed. It will never be. It will stay the same. And you need to understand that. You need to believe that. You need to trust what Jesus has said. Amen. So in order for you to take, to receive the full grasp of what the Holy Spirit, of what Jesus can do, all you need to do is to allow the Holy Spirit. And the Holy Spirit, there's only one thing that he wants to do now. He wants to come in and flip the table around. Amen. He wants to come. There are so many tables. There are so many tables. Leuna tepeli. And dambe toko kine. Nam takane lai. Ebena katana wane torano chisu. Me bata kele kome bikenda. But the only way is for the Holy Spirit to come in, flip the table, and change your life, and start cleansing the temple from inside out. Amen. The Holy Spirit wants to begin the cleansing process right from the inside. Amen. He wants to flip the table. I'm going to read up to you what it says. It says, Jesus went into the temple of God. Remember, it's the temple of God. The Bible says that God said that my house. Nungu wale nalo mandra tamata. Amen. That's what he says. Your body is the temple. Your body is the temple. And that temple right now needs cleansing. That temple right now needs cleansing. And I mean deep cleaning. Deep cleaning. There are some hidden agendas inside that temple that needs to be cleansed right now as we speak. Amen. If we want to go with God in the year 2022, that temple needs cleansing. And I mean deep cleaning. Some tables not just needed to be wiped, but needs to be flipped. Okay, some tables needs to be flipped and be removed out of your life. This is what Jesus says. Drove out all those who bought and sold in the temple and overturned the tables of the money changers. In the time that this story was mentioned, the only thing that Jesus found in that temple is the table of money changers. Don't get me wrong, it is still the problem in churches nowadays. People are after money instead of the presence of God. Okay, but this is one thing that I'm going to say. There are so many other tables on top of money changers, tables inside the church now. Sa lebutale na be matangali tepeli, sa sangwala ngani tepeli, ni be so ilabo, ni be boli. Sa lebutale na be matangali tepeli and the kautomai. There are so many other tables apart from the tables of money changers. There are so many tables that we have set up in our churches, in our denomination, that is not biblical. And we need to allow the Holy Spirit to flip those tables. Not only flip it, but remove the table completely. Because he wants to do something new. The Holy Spirit wants to do something new. Let's just not enjoy the new year. You must enjoy the new process. You must enjoy the new cleansing power of the Holy Spirit to come in and change something in your life, so that now you can say we have a blessed new year, because we have the Holy Spirit that is doing something new in our lives. Like I said, there are so many other tables on top of money changes, tables for money changes. The church has been used nowadays as a business. We Christians, we don't do business inside the church. Yes, you can do business as a family. You can do business as an individual and as a believer, but not as a church. We don't mix business with the presence of God. They don't go together. They don't work together. They will never reason together. They will never stay together. The church will just go on its way with the presence of God as our priority. Business is outside of the church. You can do business as a person, you can do business as a couple, you can do business as a family, but not as a church. We don't do business and church together. The presence of God will always be the presence of God. It must be the priority of every Christian, of every believer, but not business. This is the reason why Jesus came into the temple, because they want to mix business with the temple of the Lord. They want to mix business with the presence. Prosperity and the presence of God will never work together. They will never go together. And he says, the Bible says that they overturned the tables of the money changers. But there are other few tables that we have. The tables of new doctrines. Some other new doctrines have been introduced into our churches that is not biblical, that is not godly, that is not right. And those doctrines must be flipped and be removed completely. There are so many things that we are doing in the church. When we see things that causes confusion in our hearts, we must question that. We must ask the Holy Spirit to enlighten us in that area, whether it is right or it is wrong, whether it is godly or it is not. Amen. The Holy Spirit, the Bible says that he will guide you into all truth. So the Holy Spirit will never cause confusion. The Holy Spirit will guide you into all truth. If something that you have seen that is not biblical, that is not according to the word of God, know for sure that the Holy Spirit wants to come in and flip the table around. And you must allow him to flip the table around. Amen? The table of false doctrine. The table of entertainment. This is something that has been brought into the church right now. The tables of entertainment. We do not entertain people. We are not in the presence of God to entertain people. We are in the presence of God to worship God. The Holy Spirit will never want to waste his time on entertainers. He will give his time to worshipers. That's why Jesus says, there will come a time where you will never worship on the mountains or in the temple. You will worship the Father in spirit and in truth. The Holy Spirit, I will say again, will never want to waste his time on entertainers. He will give his time to worshipers, true worshipers. So the table of entertainment has already been set in our churches, in our denominations. And the Holy Spirit wants to come in, flip the table of entertainment, and set up a table for true worshipers inside our churches. Money changers is one of the tables that Jesus flipped. But now we have set other tables on top of the table of money, for money changers. Number one is table for money changers. Number two is tables for false doctrine. Number three is tables of entertainment. Beloved, we are not called to be entertainers. We are called to be worshipers. That's who we are. That's what we are called for. God saved you. God anointed you. God calls you to be true worshipers, not to be entertainers. So you are not in the church to entertain the people. You are not in the church to entertain the visitors. We are in the church to entertain the presence of God. We do what we do for the glory of God and God alone. For us singers, we sing for the presence of God. We musicians, we play instruments for the presence of God. We are not doing what we do to entertain the people. And that is one of the tables that has been set nowadays. And we need to allow the Holy Spirit to flip the table. When the Holy Spirit flips the table of entertainment, things will change. One song, it takes one song for the presence of the Holy Spirit to come in and do as he please. He will wreck us up. He will mess up everything when he comes. But Jesus, the Holy Spirit, will never do that if we are not willing to give him the privilege to come in and flip the table. Once you give the Holy Spirit to allow him, give him the time and allow him the privilege to come in and flip the table, you will witness that he will mess everything up about your life. He will mess everything up about your program. He will mess everything up about your ministry. He will mess everything up about your plans. But you must allow him to come in and flip the table. And listen, in verse 13, and he said to them, it is written, my house shall be called a house of prayer, but you have made it a den of thieves. I want you to understand this. He said, my house shall be called a house of prayer. That works on both ways. Number one, it works for the temple, the church. Number two, it works for the individual, the body, your life, your spirit, which is the temple of the Holy Spirit. It works. It has never changed. You are to be a man and woman of prayer. And the church is meant to be the house of prayer, not the house of good entertainment, not the house of good singing, not the house of good music. It must be the house of prayer. Amen. It must be the house of prayer. You know, it's a sad thing to see churches nowadays. They introduce the style of the world. Different lights, smoke machine. You know, that's the problem when we don't experience the presence of God. The likes of what Moses experienced in the book, in the Old Testament. In the tabernacle, that the smoke came down from heaven that represents the presence of God. That is the problem of not allowing the Holy Spirit to minister into our hearts, to to allow him to flip the tables. Because when we don't experience the presence of God, we want to make the presence of God. We want to create our own presence. We want to create our own vision of the presence of God. We bring lights that are used in nightclubs, in pubs. They are the ones who do blinking different colors of lights. We don't do that in the presence of God. We don't do that in the house of God, which is called the house of prayer. We don't do that. We are different. We don't do smokes. The only smoke that we need to feel in churches is the smoke of the presence of God. That is the only thing. But because we have set up those tables of entertainment, we allow the influence of the world to be brought inside the church. It has never changed. The temple has been called the house of prayer then. It will still be called the house of prayer now. Your body, which is the temple of the Holy Spirit, was meant to be the house of prayer then. It is still meant to be the house of prayer now. And listen to what he says. My house shall be called a house of prayer. That's the foundation that's settled. But listen to what happens here. Note what Jesus says. He didn't mention the devil here. He says, but you have made it a den of thieves. Not the devil. Not the devil. Who is the devil here? The devil is the thief. According to what Jesus says, the thief comes not but to steal and kill and destroy. But I have come that they might have life, and life more abundantly. So you give the privilege to the devil. You give the privilege to the thief to come in, because he says, you have made it. It's not the devil. We have made it. It's our own decision. We bring the world inside the church. It's our own doings. So we need to change that. And we need to change that now. My house shall be called a house of prayer, but you have made it a den of thieves. Tonight, this morning, you have to change. You have to allow the Holy Spirit. You have to ask Jesus, because you are the ones who have made the house of God, the house of prayer, to be a den of thieves. You know, you invite the thief, you invite the devil to come into that house. You are the ones. You are the one. You have made it a den of thieves. Not the devil. Not Satan. Not those demonic spirits. You have made them come in. Not only for them to come in and go back out. A den, which means they will come and live in there. Who caused that to happen? You caused that to happen. But now the Holy Spirit is speaking to you that he wants to come in and flip the table around so that you have life and life more abundantly. Jesus said, the thief cometh not but to steal and kill and destroy, but I have come that they might have life and life more abundantly. My house shall be called a house of prayer. It has never changed, but you have made it a den of thieves. We introduce other tables inside the church nowadays. The tables of false doctrine, the tables of money making, the tables of entertainment. There is no more true worship anymore. We need to go back in the old type of worship, and we need to go back to that. And don't mind the lesser tale. Come on, when you want to come to Tumanda Nasala Kapara Rai, Kapakatarani, Lala Makasi, Bena Nasaladin, Indosakunea, Tome Lakotik Makina. We needed to go back to that old time religion. We need to go back there. Where people are reverent, where they reverence the presence of God. We need to go back there, and we need to go back there now. It is written, my house shall be called a house of prayer, but you have made it a den of thieves. Let's not blame the devil. We give the devil the privilege to come in and run riot inside our churches, inside the house which is called the house of prayer. We change it into a den of thieves, which means the demonic spirit, they live inside the church now. Why? Because there is no more presence. Why? Because there is no more connection. Why? Because there is no more power. We don't sense the presence of God, and yet we want to create our own version of the presence. We bring different kinds of lights. We bring different kinds of music. We bring different kinds of dances. We bring different kinds of things that the world live for. And when we bring that and implement that inside the churches, that's why we never felt the presence of God anymore. And the Holy Spirit is coming to you right now, wherever you are listening in from. He wants to flip the table around. Let him do it. He knows what he's doing. Let him do it. In order for us to go through this new year, you've got to allow the Holy Spirit to do something new in your life. Note the difference. The devil didn't do it. We blame the devil, but the devil didn't do it. You make it a house, a den of thieves. You are the ones who introduce the table of entertainment. You are the one who introduces the table of false doctrine. You are the ones who introduces the table of compromising. A compromising table is already set in our churches, and we need to allow the Holy Spirit to come in and flip it around so that we can change. It's my prayer. It's my prayer tonight or this morning that you, as you go into the year of 2022, please let the Holy Spirit to come in and flip the table around. It is for your own good. It is for the best, better for your family. It is better for your marriage. And it's better for you as an individual. Amen. Will you please close your eyes and bow your heads? I want to pray for you. Nobody knows the type of table that has already been set in your heart. Nobody knows the type of table that you set in your family as a standard in your family. But this is the thing. The Holy Spirit is speaking to you, and he wants you to flip the table around. You need to flip the table around. Get rid of the table of entertainment. You are not called and saved to become entertainers. You are called to be a true worshiper. That's who you are. That's your calling. That's what God wants from you, to be a true worshiper. Amen. If you need Jesus, wherever you are, you can pray and ask God to help you. But I'm going to pray for you now. And that will be the end of our service. That will be at the end of this short clip for each and everyone. This is just to encourage you. Allow the Holy Spirit to come in and flip the table around. He is doing his cleansing job in this new year. If you want a new dimension, if you want a new level, you must allow him to do new things in your life. And that begins with him flipping the table around. Wakilikila, na tepeli ni lotumbalago, na tepeli ni tuwagaitutu, na tepeli ni wakatara, and the sang ni kadibi mentandori wakatara, wakatasusua, and the kadibi mentamangaraba nakalu. So please, live according to that. And it's my prayer that the Lord will bless you and change you into the person that he wants you to be. Please close your eyes and bow your heads. Father, I praise you. Na wali usara turanga na ngunungo. Na wale utamangu na ngono ni batara. Na wale uno nomo ni beba rotaki. Na wale uno nomo ni stavi besi tavi turanga. Kime mi babi ni benaka tekem. Father, we thank you for your word. Thank you for your presence. Thank you for everything that you are doing for us in this new year that we are going through. Lord, we commit our lives into your hands. Holy Spirit, come and lead us. Come and do as you please in our lives and in our hearts. Flip the table around. We are willing to be changed by you. And we are willing to walk with you. We are willing to live with you. We are willing to give you the privilege to lead us into all truth. We don't want to be led by the church. We don't want to be led by the people. We don't want to be led by the government. We want to be led by you, the Holy Spirit. You know what is best for us. And we commit our lives into your hands. Father, to those who are listening to this sermon, Lord, I praise you and I thank you for their lives. And I pray that you will bless them. For they have given their time, they have given the privilege of listening to your word. They're giving the opportunity to you, Lord, to come in and change their lives around. Lord, we thank you in advance that you will flip those tables around and give them what they need in this time, in this day and age, for them to live a holy life before you. Holy Spirit, once again, we acknowledge your presence. We love you. We adore you. We worship you. We exalt you. We lift you up. We are thankful for all that you are going to do. To those who are driving and listening to this sermon, Lord, I pray that you will bless them, that you will encourage them to give you the privilege to go in and flip the table around for you to be glorified in their lives. Thank you, Jesus, that you will show up through the working of the Holy Spirit in our lives, that the Holy Spirit will reveal you to us in such an extent that we will never want to go back into our old lifestyle. We thank you, Lord, and we praise you. Heavenly Father, we give you the glory. We give you the honor. Thank you, Jesus, for giving your life for us. And thank you, Holy Spirit, for revealing the Son of God to us. And we lift up your name. We exalt your name. We magnify your name. We will never forget to give you back all the glory and the honor to be yours alone. We ask all these things in Jesus' matchless and wonderful name we pray. And everybody say amen and amen. Amen. Nomini lo lomo lewo na kalona, nomini ala tambu. Dono we tumbero na buni kandena ni tuga tawani ke mami. And I come in na ike, and we sing a kadang ni mami mbula ni ke lasa wo. Me kakua saranga ni mando. Amen, amen, amen. Na wale usara. Amen. Thank you once again for listening. Thank you for tuning in. Thank you for giving your time to be part of this. This is our first sermon for 2022 in this ministry, in this platform. And I want to give God the glory for everything that he has done for us. Blessed, happy new year to each and every one of you. And remember, let him come in and flip the table around for your own good. Stay safe, stay blessed. Welcome to 2022. God bless you all. Now, one.